Two comments, Jed. One, yep. just my yep. own anecdote. I've been putting moringa powder from Coolie Coolie in my smoothies, and I also feel great. But I also feel great without the moringa powder in the smoothie. But the interesting thing I have noticed with the moringa powder, and this yep. has been repeatable, I've been wearing a continuous glucose monitor for about 3 years now, and the
hardcore.
So hardcore, you have no idea. But my typical smoothie is some a little bit of kale and blueberries, avocado, and collagen powder. And adding the moringa powder in there, the blueberries, it doesn't really raise my glucose levels much. So the smoothie itself without the moringa powder, you know, brings me to about postprandial glucose, like 105. And the moringa powder consistently lowers that by, I don't know, 7 to 10 units. Don't have any idea what's going on mechanistically. I'm sure someone's going to study it. And there's been some interesting research on type 2 diabetes. And I don't want to go there because we have to get to safety, which is a really important chunk of this Q&A. But I thought that was an interesting anecdote. The second comment is there was a live question. Sorry. Go ahead.
Absolutely. So you can't say something like that and not have me interrupt and say, yeah. So the biggest medical indication for moringa leaf powder is going to be, I think, diabetes. And that has, that
You're
is
kidding.
Under, no, not. That is under active investigation, blood glucose control.
You're kidding.
We have a review that shows there were six, not all good studies at all, and they were all tiny, showing an effect of moringa leaves or moringa leaf powder. We can talk about that another time. I've even talked about it on a podcast.
So my N of one was, you know, actually probably real.
Very interesting. Now, if all 100 million of your viewers are wearing glucose monitors, we can put them together and have a study.